thank you. I mean, it's definitely, it does feel nice, but you know, it's just a temporary thing you can really get attached to. What feels nicer is that we are 2-4-2 in hockey East right now. Like I told my teammates after the game, it's always a team effort. You know, I think that Merrimack and Hollycrows, they both played well. They made us work for it. I mean, credit to Merrimack for what they had to show us in the last 2 minutes of the game. But luckily for me, I had my teammates in front of me. They were out there. They were, you know, blocking the shots, protecting the net. So, I mean, kudos to them. Yeah, you know, I think that even the non-conference games have helped us to get where we need to be. But to be honest, even during the Hollycrows and Merrimack games, we had some moments during intermissions where we needed to sit down and change some things, make some adjustments. But overall, I think that we are happy with where we are at. I just think that we cannot get too comfortable with ourselves. That can be actually our biggest threat. But I think that overall, we're more than ready for any team in Hockey East at this point.
What's working so well for you right now? Does the game seem slow?
I mean, I don't think it seems slow. We just have a good system. I think our coaches did an excellent job preparing us for this season. The team is confident. That's one of the most important things. But like I said, even during the Hollycrows and Merrimack games, like we were there. We were out there, but we played too nice. And we know that playing against the best teams in our league, we cannot just be nice. We have to play dirty hockey, and that's what we're trying to get ready for this week, yeah.
What are you most looking forward to about hockey's play?
You know, it's been, for me personally, it's been a long time since we were actually in that, okay, let's go time hockey's games. So I think that I can speak on behalf of all of my teammates that we're so excited to face those really good teams in hockey's. It's going to be a good measurement for us to see where we're at. But like I said, I mean, we're more than ready for that. I know that BU, they have some good forwards. UConn is a really strong team with the good goaltending. But, I mean, I know that we have such a short turnaround. We had a mandatory day off on Monday because we played Friday. We skated on Saturday. We had another game on Sunday, but I think even the 3 or 4 practices before BU and then UConn are going to get us ready for the weekend.
You said you guys have played dirty hockey. What do you mean by that?
You know, we cannot be too nice. Like, there's some moments where we're letting our opponents take the puck so easily in the corners in front of the net, and we just need to battle hard. And I know that Alex Gray made a good comment last week about playing UVM hockey and what it really takes, you know, like, we know that we have to show up every day. We have to work hard. We know what it means on paper, and we just have to make sure that those aren't just words that we leave in a locker room once we hit the ice.
What's up with the Taylor Swift post game?
I couldn't even tell you. I don't know. No, I mean, it's a team thing, I guess. But I guess, yeah, that's about it. Yeah, it's our first roadie of the year. I think that the only thing that might be different is for our underclassmen, especially the freshmen. You know, they're excited about it. They keep asking about how does it feel like, and I think it's gonna be even a little different this time because we, like I said, we play BU, then we play UConn, and next day there's only about 22 hours to recover and get ready for another opponent. So there's going to be much less time to, you know, go through the strategic plans and just to kind of see the overall outcomes of the games that we could take some takeaways from. But I think that, you know, like, the excitement is just, it's just there, and that's what's the most important thing. And I think that's what's going to get us rolling on the road.
Thank you.